Hello, welcome to the video. We're going to summarize a YouTube video and we're going to count token usage using LangChain. We're going to be using the YouTube loader, OpenAI, and we're also going to be looking at a translation model at the end, which is free. So the first thing we're going to be doing is we're going to install LangChain, pip install LangChain. Sacramoses, you get NAG to use that, so I've just included that as well. From TQDM, we're going to import TQDM. That gives us our nice progress bars when we're importing models and when the things are happening, which take a few seconds. We're also going to be using from LangChain callbacks, import get OpenAI callback. That is what we will be using to count our token usage. So that line there, and also the async.io, those two lines of all the token usage. If you're not interested in monitoring your token usage, you can ignore those. Now, the new bit is going to be the YouTube loader, which we import from langchain.documentLoaders. What we will be doing is getting the video ID. If you don't know how to get the video ID, a quick show. If you go to YouTube, find the video you want, and it's up there. It's after the watch question mark V equals. So yeah. Once you've got that, paste that in. Now the documentation I believe was, I don't know if it was actually totally up to date. What you need to do is actually put video ID into here when you create the YouTube loader object or the instantiate the class. Results, let me just show you the results. So run all that and then we'll run this, and the result should give us a big load of text, which it has done. It's gone off to YouTube and it saves you having to separately go off and extract all of the YouTube text using the YouTube-transcript-API module. Under the bonnet is actually using that, I gather, but yeah, it just saves you a bit of code. It's neater. So that's the result. Just minimize that. Once you've got that, it's actually if we just print the type of it, so type, it's not actually a standard Python primitive. If you look at it, it is print type of the result. It is a list, but we need to get the list and we need to split it into chunks, and then we then pass the chunks into OpenAI because we can't pass it all in one fell swoop because of the size limit, which is currently 4096, I think. So we've got the result. We pass the result into the text splitter. Text splitter then splits up into, I've set really big chunk sizes there. I want to decrease those. I've also set a chunk overlap. The chunk overlap basically gives you slightly better accuracy. You don't have to have that. So that was the text. And the text was a discussion about Bitcoin and about why it's better than gold and the growth and 140%, blah, blah, blah. So yeah, you can do this with any video you want. Obviously it does need the subtitles and the captions on YouTube. Right, okay, so next, LLM equals OpenAI, temperature is zero. We set the temperature to zero because we want to ensure accuracy with minimal creativity, shall we say. The OpenAI API key, because we are actually going to be using OpenAI, and it's going to cost us some money. And this is where we use with get underscore OpenAI underscore callback as CB. And then everything inside here will then get returned as the callback. So then you get the tokens, prompt tokens, completion tokens, and the cost. And I'm just setting a variable here to for when the chain runs. I'm only passing the first two sentences, or sorry, the first two chunks into the chain. Save money, save tokens. So when I run this, let's see, running now. I've obviously run it already, but this will obviously do it all over again. That's quite quick. Right, a concise summary of the following. So it's actually summarized. One, two. Two chunks of 2,000. And total tokens, 909. Prompt tokens, 815. Completion tokens. So prompt tokens is basically what I passed in. Completion tokens is what you get back. And there you see 0.018. So about 2 cents, which, yeah, about 1.5p each time, but it does add up. So there we go. So we've actually managed to identify how much it's costing us each time. What I did there was I actually set the summary to a variable name called tx, which you saw just up here. So when the chain runs, you do chain.run, and then tx is the name of my variable. And then what I'm doing is I'm just using a sentence transformer along with I tried Google. That one was a bit hit and miss. Ignore that one. Back, let's comment that out. And instead, I tried this one, and it's Marion MT model, Marion tokenizer. So again, Marion tokenizer from pre-trained, which is saying we want to use the pre-trained model. And then we pass the input text into the model and we encode it, and then we translate it. And here we go at the end, it's translated it to German. So the translation bit is just kind of I just wanted to show that not everything costs money. If you can combine, so the YouTube part was free. The OpenAI part where it was doing the summarizing cost you money. That's why we got the token usage. And then again, at the end, I just did some translation. So tokenizer. So we did an encode and then we did a decode. If you want to modify it and mess about with it, you can. It's going to be on GitHub. So obviously this was English to German. There's many, many more. If you go on Hugging Face, you can see all of them. So Hugging Face really is like GitHub for language models, for AI models in general. So I'll put this on GitHub. Feel free to copy it, modify it. Hopefully you might get some benefit from what I've shown here, actually, because most of the rest of the stuff is out on the internet already. But I believe this syntax is relatively new, and you won't find that in, I don't think you'll come across that in much of the documentation. So yeah, just make use of LangChain with the YouTube loader. It's got a text splitter. So a lot of the things which you would have done manually previously, even in kind of, even in like the world of web scraping, you'd be doing a lot of these things manually. You'd be using requests. You'd be possibly using regular expressions. You'd be creating lists and appending to lists, iterating through the text. So yeah, this just makes life very easy with your text splitter. You split the document and you get your result and you pass the result into the model. Text up to 2. You could increase that and then you could summarize more of the video. I've basically summarized the first two chunks of 2,000 characters. There we go. So I'll put this on GitHub. Feel free to look at it, modify it, and I'll be back soon. So remember, tokens, token usage, cost. And that varies depending on which model you're choosing, which OpenAI model you're choosing. So thanks for watching, and don't be afraid to experiment, test stuff out, break stuff. Take this example, the link's in the description. Use it, run it, break it. Thank you.